Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Exotic Astrology. Nice to see you back. And I was asked a question that how do we judge the strength of the ascendant? So today I will list down certain factors, certain points which we can consider. And by looking at these points, you can also judge the strength of your ascendant, right, in the horoscope, because ascendant is the most important house that defines everything. Depending on the ascendant, we decide, we come to know actually which planet is sitting in which house, and the results that a planet gives depends on the house which it sits in and which house it lords. Right? So a planet in a particular house can give a totally different result if it is in a particular ascendant, because and compared to another ascendant, because they will rule different houses for every ascendant. All right, so therefore this is something very crucial. This is the first thing that we should judge whenever we are judging any horoscope, in fact, for marriage, for career, for spiritual life, for everything. This works actually. This is unanimous. This is irrespective of whichever area you want to judge any house in astrology. You must judge from the ascendant first, right? If you don't do this and you directly jump to that house, so suppose somebody wants to know about marriage, then you go and jump to the seventh house. That's the classic disaster which comes out, which people do, that directly going to the seventh house, career 10th house directly, sixth house. No. We must go through the ascendant first. Okay, and when I say ascendant, it is not just, wherever your ascendant lord is sitting, you know, that is exalted, debilitated, you know, then it's good, bad. It's not like that, okay? Nobody has a perfect ascendant. And therefore, the factors which I will tell will hold true to some extent for everybody, okay, to certain degree, good or bad, both. So do not expect that whatever I say will be positive for everybody, okay? And therefore, as usual, if you are new to the channel, please subscribe to it below. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your ascendant, you can find my website down in the description section below. God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him irrespective of your ascendant. Okay, and some people had been telling me of this, the mic quality. Well, there have been some audio and some software updates in my laptop, because of which from the last 10-15 videos, some people have been commenting about that the audio quality has gone down. I don't know what is the problem with my microphone, but if this continues, maybe I will replace the microphone with another one and then I will check. But now I have made some changes, so let me try and test if it still works. Okay, so the ascendant is the first house. It is the Lagna, the rising sign. Okay, that is very clear for those who are new to astrology. But what is the ascendant actually? The ascendant decides who you are, who you want to be. How do you view life in general? Planet in the ascendant affects you very much. The traits of that planet. Either is good or bad. Good, bad means either it's a natural malefic or natural benefic. Or it is lord of trine or trines or the lord of the dusthanas. Either ways, it will always affect you. Very much. You are very vulnerable to that planet. It could be good or bad also. It is that which if that area of your life is good, then your life is like Christmas. It's like heaven always. But if that area of life is under some kind of challenge, then that can ruin you totally. Okay, so many people will have planets in the ascendant. Okay, planets means one planet or more. Sometimes people have like four or five planets in the ascendant, I've seen. So, therefore, if you have planets in the ascendant, you must make sure that those planets are properly functioning in your chart, those areas. Okay, so now let us systematically start. So, the first thing that you need to do is judge the karaka for the ascendant, Yes. The Karak. Who is the Karak for the Ascendant? It is the Sun. It was, it is, and it will always be the Sun. Okay. And now people say that for men, Sun is more important. For ladies, Moon is more important. That is true. But when you are judging the Ascendant, either it's a male or female, you must judge the Sun. You must. There is no doubt on this. Okay. You must judge the Ascendant. Okay. The Sun, first of all, first planet you must judge is the Sun. Okay. Where is Sun placed? Which planets are helping the Sun? Is the Sun getting help from its natural friends like Moon, Mars, and Jupiter especially? Is the Sun conjunct these planets? Then this uplifts the power of the Sun. Okay. Because then he feels that I am having a certain amount of influence and power. I have people who listen to me. Okay. So that can be very good for the Sun. So that is the first planet you judge. So you have to check where is your Sun placed, you know, which house is it. Then which planets the Sun is conjunct, as I said. The sign is also very important. Okay. Now, many times people may have a debilitated Sun and then they will comment below the videos, oh, my Sun is not good, but what you are saying doesn't match with me. Okay. Well, that is because of your naive understanding of astrology, that you think one planet decides everything. No. When I say the Sun, I do not mean the Sun in the Lagna chart only. You have to check the placement of the Sun in your Navamsha chart also. You have to check the placement of the Sun in your Dasamsa chart also. Okay. In all the divisional charts, you must check the placement of the Sun. That is very, 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 very crucial. That is the first thing you should do. Yes, he is the Karaka for the first house. Ultimately, Sun is the king. So Sun is the existence. So Sun represents those things which give you a feeling of being lively in this world. Lively means not that there is a lot of beauty and charm and, you know, there's a lot of attractive things going on. That's Venus. But what are those things which excite you suddenly out of nowhere? Those are the things which the Sun represents. What is that when you think you get excited very much? Okay. So therefore, we must check the Sun. It's very crucial because, see, if the Sun is well placed, then there is a greater degree of possibility that the things that excite us, we work more towards it. Okay. So therefore, the Sun is very crucial. And when we work towards it, we get, there is a higher possibility of getting recognition or name or fame. That is why you will see horoscopes where the 10th Lord or the Ascendant Lord is very well placed, but Sun is not very well placed. Then you may understand that they might need a higher degree of motivation. Okay. And of course, now there are many actors, many millionaires, billionaires, trillionaires, quadrillionaires. Okay. There are many religious leaders. There are millions and millions and billions of people who have a bad or weak Sun. Okay. So again, as I said, having a weak or a bad or a debilitated Sun doesn't mean that your life is ruined. Okay. So if that was true, then whoever was born between when Sun is in Libra, then everybody's life would be ruined. It's not like that. Okay. So don't think like that and don't take it the other way around also. Oh, Sun is not good, so not a problem. So it is not like that. Okay. You need to judge the horoscope in totality. That is the big mistake we do. So do not do that mistake. Don't make one position absolute and don't ignore any placement. Okay. That is very important. Now, the second thing you should do is, what is that? Yes, you should judge the Lord of the Ascendant in the Kal Purush Kundli. Who is the Kal Purush Lord of the Ascendant? Yes, it is Mangal. It is Mars, because he rules Aries. Mars will show the vigor and vitality that you have for going ahead in life. Okay. That is very, 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 very crucial. Mars is very crucial for the Ascendant. Okay. So therefore, you must judge Mars. Now, Mars is a very interesting planet. Sometimes people think that exalted Mars is good, a debilitated Mars is bad. I do not view it like that. Well, I try to view the placement of Mars depending on the, of course, Mars has its individual placement, which is very crucial. There's no doubt about it. But there are certain horoscopes for which exalted Mars is good and it can be terrible sometimes. Yes, an exalted Mars can totally ruin you your entire life, and a debilitated Mars can be the best thing you can ever have in the horoscope. Okay. So therefore, Mars, the placement of Mars should be judged along with the other planets, which means suppose a person has too many planets in water signs or female signs, okay, and he or she is into areas like, you know, healthcare or nourishing others, or, you know, nursing, or like taking care of people emotionally, these kind of things, then a debilitated Mars can be very good, because that can give you more tolerance, more power, more patience to handle emotional stuff, you know, because sometimes people who have an exalted Mars, they're not necessarily impulsive, but they can lack patience sometimes, which means they might feel that, oh, this is nonsense, you know, I know it's like this and I will do it like this. So the exalted Mars, people need to cultivate patience so that they can understand that everything may not go their own way. But now, suppose the majority of the planets are in, you know, fire signs, or the person has a very strong sun or ascendant lord, and the person is into something like government or military or armed forces, you know, something which requires lot of strictness is required, you know, it's like punctuality is required, a lot of discipline is required. For that, an exalted Mars is very good. So in that case, if the person has a debilitated Mars or a Mars which is in a event sign, that can be terrible for that person. Okay, so therefore you must judge Mars in after you compare the entire horoscope. Okay, which means you have to know where the flow of the horoscope is happening. If you don't know the flow, and if you just judge like this, oh, Mars is in Cancer, this is very bad. No, it's not bad. You have to see where. The same thing is for spirituality also. Exalted Mars can be good, a debilitated Mars can be best sometimes. Okay. What kind of practice is the person into? If the person is into some kind of practice like Ashtanga Yoga, then I have seen it is very good to have an exalted Mars, because that gives you a lot of vitality and strength, power and vigor in the body. But if the person is into like Bhakti Yoga or is into Gyan Yoga, then I have seen the Mars placed in even sign is a bit better, because then the person can be not too much, you know, delving in the external realm and more focusing on the inside. Now again, as I said, nothing is good or bad. It depends on how the horoscope is. Then the third thing you need to judge is Jupiter. Jupiter is very important, not because he's a friend of the sun and moon. That is not the reason. Because he's ultimately Jeev Karak. The Jeev comes into this body, which through sun actually. So Jupiter kind of becomes like Mars through the sun. So it's like Jupiter is the pure consciousness, you know? That is Chit in a pure form. And then when Jupiter thinks that, okay, I need a separate identity from God now, which means I want to be like the sun, which means everybody should revolve around me. Then he needs a body, and that's what Mars is. So these three are very important. All right. So therefore, you must judge Jupiter. What is the situation of Jupiter? Is Jupiter somehow associating with the Ascendant or Lord of the Ascendant? It's very, very, very crucial, because then the person has a greater degree of accepting things in life. Because the person, if somehow Jupiter is well placed, or with the Moon, or with the Ascendant Lord, or even in trines, then I have seen, not on an absolute sense, on a relative sense, I have seen. And if the Lagnesh and Sun, Moon and the Ninth Lord is well placed, then these people, although they might have a lot of challenges in life, but they understand that, you know, law of karma is there. It is their own mistakes. You know, they don't go and blaming others and shooting others. Oh, you ruined my life. He did this. He ditched me. She ditched me. He cheated me. She cheated me. This happened. That happened. No, the person doesn't do like that, I have seen. Because the person is aware of the chit. Yes, that's very strange, that even at the level of chitta, which is the contaminated consciousness, the person can sometimes behave as if he or she is in chit, which is pure consciousness. Okay, And that is what is Sat Chit Ananda, full of eternity, knowledge and bliss. That is what the soul is. You know, and the person knows, as Krishna says in the Gita, Nayanam Chindanti Shastrani, Nayanam Dahati Pavakaha. You cannot destroy the soul, you cannot touch, you cannot cut, you cannot beat the soul, you can't do anything. You are beyond matter. I mean, why you are suffering? Because you think, I am related to this body, I am related to a man, I am related to a woman, and that person did not give me happiness, that person left me, cheated me. So that is why I am unhappy in life. But actually, nothing of this material world can actually touch us if we are at the level of chit. Okay, so therefore Jupiter will give you very nice clues for how to judge an ascendant. Okay, and next you must judge, of course, the planets in the ascendant. Okay, this I told in the beginning, but this is a fact. This is the next point which I am stressing. You have to judge which planets are in the ascendant. Which means, is there a natural malefic or is there a natural benefic? Okay. Is the planet exalted? Is the planet in debility? Is the planet afflicted? Okay. Or is the ascendant having no planets, but is it afflicted? Okay. So many times people say, oh, I don't have a planet in my ascendant. So what? No, it's not like that. You check the sun, you check Mars, you check Jupiter, and you check the Lord of the Ascendant. Okay, so the fourth point, as I mentioned, you have to check the Ascendant. Very, 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 very crucial. The type of planets that are in the Ascendant controls the entire chart, actually. Okay, therefore, you will see if somebody has a natural benefic in the Lagna, okay, or if one or more, then it is very, in my limited experience I have seen, it is very easy to deal with that person. You don't have to take a lot of stress. The person is like accepting more things in life. So if you can very easily have a nice conversation with such a person, I have seen. And I know somebody who, one of my friends, not a very close friend, he has a natural malefic in the Lagna. And I will not take name of the malefic because that might create unnecessary fears. And he's a very difficult person to deal with. Whenever I talk with him, oh, you know, I'm going to this country to do this. And then he's like, why do you go there? You could have gone there. I'm like, okay, I'm going to eat this. Why do you eat this? That's not good. You should do that. So it's like negation, denial, and always complaining and, you know, creeping, criticizing. These kind of natures can be there if a person has a natural malefic. And that is why you will see it's very difficult to deal with these people. Okay, and therefore, they might have a difficult married life because that planet aspects the seventh house. So you are doing the same. You are just finding faults with your marriage partner. That is why your marriage is not working. And then you are thinking, oh, my seventh lord is exalted. Why is my married life not working? Yes, that is the reason, because you have challenges in the ascendant. So, therefore, the ascendant is very important. All right. And the last factor is we must judge the lord of the ascendant. Okay. In my experience, I have seen if the lord of the ascendant is conjunct Sun, Jupiter, or Mars, or it is in the ascendant, or it is in Kendras or in Trikonas, then it is relatively very strong. Yes, the ascendant lord can exclusively show your focus. What is that which you always want to do in life? It is like you are going and sitting there. Okay. So now the ascendant lord's placement is also very important after you judge all these things. But that's why I put it in the last, because that's the first thing we do. We directly go and check, oh, Lagnesh is in 6th house, Lagnesh is in 10th house. This is good, that is bad, blah, blah, blah. No, that's the last thing you should do. Okay. In traditional Vedic astrology, the ascendant lord is the last thing we look at when we are judging the strength of the Lagna. Okay. We need to start from the basics. We need to understand who is the Karak. We need to understand what the Lagna is, the body, you know, the conception of the soul trying to enjoy separately from God, which is the sun. And what the soul is ultimately, that is Jupiter. It is Jiva Karak. All right. So you can analyze these 5 points and try to see. Now, again, as I said, certain things will be good, certain things will be bad. So you have to exactly know when you are doing a consultation for somebody, where is the problem coming from? Because if you just do discrete things like this, oh, my sun is exalted. Now, sometimes people will have a debilitated Mars and an exalted sun. So how do you reconcile? Yes, you have to do that. Sometimes people will have an exalted Mars and a sun in Libra, debilitated. And then you are thinking, what should I say, right? Yes, you have to know what sun represents. You have to know what Mars represents. You have to know what Jupiter represents, okay? You have to know what these planets represent. Only then you can say, oh, your ascendant is strong in these areas and weak in these areas, okay? So, therefore, it is very crucial that we learn these things from the basics. And you might be thinking, oh, but we already know these things. But let me tell you, 99% of the people are not using these three planets. They are only using the ascendant and the lord of the ascendant. They have no clue about the sun, what Mars or Jupiter is doing. Okay. So you can use these five steps and then judge the strength of the ascendant. And that decides everything. If the ascendant is strong or it is good, then 99% of the problems of life are solved. Even if they are not solved, they don't matter you. Okay. And if the ascendant is not very good, if these five factors are not supporting the ascendant, then even if the person has a lot of things, the person can be born in a millionaire family or a billionaire or a trillionaire or a very greatly elevated sage or a sadhu's family, the person ruins everything. Okay. Have you seen people being born into very spiritual religious families or very rich families and they are just wasting everything? Whatever their parents gave them, they have not inherited and they have wasted and they have ruined the lives of everybody, including themselves. Okay. So that is the conclusion of how to judge the ascendant. All right. Thank you very much. And if you are new to the channel, please subscribe to it down below. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your ascendant, you can go to my website down in the description section. All right. God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him.